Clark instinctively drew her handbag closer to her body as the man approached her. Sure, the man didn't appear out of the ordinary, pinstripe suit, nice watch, business bag in hand, but Clark knew that anybody could harbor malicious intentions, and she wasn't going to take any chances. "Hello there. How are you today?" The man gave Clark a brilliant smile, his white teeth glinting in the sunlight. It might have just been a smile, but it set the mood of the conversation. Clark's stiff demeanor relaxed almost instantly. She returned the man's smile. "Oh, I'm quite good, how about you?" The man crossed his feet, trusting, relaxed. "Well, not amazing. I was on my way to Thompson's Books, but I've found myself quite lost. Might you be able to point me in the right direction?" The man's smile never left his face, drawing her in. Oh, well, of course Clark could help him. She knew the quiet streets of Bingham like the back of her own hand. Oh, Thompson's is only a hop, skip, and a jump away. Just take a left on Elmwood. With this she turned around, pointing her finger down the road. And you'll find yourself at Thompson's in a jiff. A sharp pain shot through Clark's head. During her last seconds of consciousness, Clark was reminded of when her brother had thrown a rock at her, back in a time when she had less worries. The man watched as Clark sank to the cement. He was glad he hadn't had to shoot her. He still felt a small pang of guilt for pistol whipping the old woman. He stooped down, grabbed Clark's handbag, and set off down the street. The man wasn't afraid of being caught, mostly because there wasn't anybody around to catch him. A setup. Everything about the man was fake. His smile, the formalities he used, his suit. All to ensure that Clark would be relaxed during the encounter, but more importantly to gain her trust. Clark didn't even think twice when she turned her back. After all, didn't the man exhibit all the signs of an ordinary person?